Now, in order to stage the beginning of a new dynasty with the coronation of Napoleon, not only the emperor himself, but also several members of his family were portrayed on multiple occasions, and among them, most prominently, his first wife, Marie-Joseph Rose Bonaparte, whom Napoleon tenderly called Joséphine. Already before their marriage in 1796, Joséphine was well known and praised for her extraordinary beauty and elegance. So for artists, of course, she was a very rewarding model, and thus, as an empress, she became the possibly most representative of all French female rulers. Apart from official stately commissions with a representative purpose, Joséphine was also an avid art lover herself, housing a considerable collection in her private retreat in Malmaison, for which she acquired works by the most prestigious artists of her generation. And one of her favorite painters is actually the author of this exceptional portrait, which is Pierre-Paul Prud'hon. Now, in distinction from the imposing propaganda of, say, painters like Jacques-Louis David, Prud'hon was known for a more lyrical and romanticizing interpretation of neoclassicism, which very much appealed to the Empress's personal taste. It was around 1805 that he received the commission to paint her portrait, and possibly by Joséphine herself. What we see here is one of several preparatory works illustrating Prud'hon's creative process before eventually finishing what would become the probably best-known representation of the Empress, a full-length portrait showing Joséphine seated in her garden at Malmaison, which is now at the Louvre in Paris. Now, within these works, this sketch must have served as sort of a close-up study of the Empress's features, who apparently also sat for the painter on this occasion. It was not necessarily always the case, since very often the artist just had to work from reproductions. And while the final result at the Louvre clearly idealizes the features of the then 40-something Joséphine, this sketch here depicts her with a remarkable realism, offering a very tangible and informal image of the sitter, while at the same time still conveying a very distinct air of ethereal grace and elegance. Her curiously wistful, almost melancholic expression, both in this and in the finished Louvre portrait, has tended to be read as sort of a prefiguration for her divorce from Napoleon in 1810, due to the fact that they couldn't have children together. Now, whether or not this psychologizing interpretation is true, it undoubtedly points to Prud'hon's special skill as a close and highly sensitive observer, and it is this quality that makes this work stand out among numerous other representations of the Empress.